Are you foolish if you keep a staffy as a pet? I want to hear your gut reaction, and I want to hear your experience. Perhaps that makes you mad because you do have a staffy that is lovely and would never hurt any child. 0845 9455 555. Ryan O'Meara publishes K9 magazine. He's on the line now. Hi, Ryan.
Good morning.
Do you think you're foolish if you keep a staffy as a pet, Ryan?
No, not at all. I think you're foolish if you keep any dog and don't train and socialise it properly or monitor its access to children. But in terms of the Staffordshire Bull Terrier as an individual breed, I go the opposite way. If people ask me, I'm thinking of getting a dog and I've got a family, what sort of breeds are ideal? I am absolutely unequivocal in saying Staffordshire Bull Terrier should be on your list of considerations. The problems occur not with this breed, but with any dog that is of a certain size and weight that hasn't been given proper training. And unfortunately, I think that there's far, far too many dogs who aren't given proper training, aren't given proper socialisation. And this is a bigger problem, and I would describe it as quite a modern problem, because I've often said to people, if you look at the dogs that we first domesticated thousands of years ago, those dogs were not attacking their owners because those dogs were given jobs to do, they had functions in life, and they were trained. The modern dog is sort of bought as a pet, for companionship, and all too many dogs are simply not given the proper amount of training. And all too many dog owners are completely blissfully or ignorantly unaware of, if you give a dog completely unrestricted access to children, you're setting yourself up for a horrible fall, and that's regardless of breed.
We've spoken on my program before about the fact that dangerous dog attacks seem to be our American gun problem. When we watch the news of Americans out of control with guns and youngsters going out with guns and killing children and things like that, we're all horrified and we think to ourselves, oh, for goodness sake, why don't they just get a grip of it? Why don't they just get rid of guns in America and then they wouldn't have so many problems? And yet we have exactly the same problem, don't we, with dogs. We have time after time after time these stories that keep rearing their ugly head of people who bring these dogs into their home. They don't train the dog, they mistreat the dog, whatever it may be, or sometimes the dog just for whatever reason turns and a child ends up having their face ripped off. When are we going to actually do something about this?
Well, I think we should do something about it. I'm uncomfortable with the comparison between a dog and a gun. A gun's only function is to kill or maim, whereas dogs are a massive, massive positive contribution, not just to society, but to the history of the world, Alan.
But it could be argued in the wrong hands, both are dangerous. In the right hands, both can be safe.
Exactly. And I think, what we know, just today, we saw some data out from Churchill Pet Insurance that said 9 out of 10 dog owners will confess their secrets to their dog, where they won't confess them to their people. And I think this shows the modern relationship between humans and dogs. And I think what we have to do as a society is say that dogs are 99.9% a massive contributor to society, but they are an animal. If you don't train your dog, and I think dogs have become the victim of their own success. People get a dog, and because it's domesticated, they think they've trained it. It comes when it's called in the house. It acts like a human, and that's another issue that people need to be aware of. Dogs are not people. They're animals. And so if you look at the serious and fatal dog attacks that we've had, and there's been 8 in the past 8 years, which is 8 too many. That's 8 people that will never grow up as a result of something that a dog did.
You know, you're describing some of these people and their stupid attitude to their dogs, but you are describing the owners of many staffies that I have spoken to. I lose track of the number of times I get a phone call on my program, and it says on my screen, you know, Steve has a staffy, loves it. I then speak to Steve, and Steve quickly starts revealing that his daughters, they sleep in the bed with the staffy. The staffy gets into his daughters' beds with them at night, and they snuggle up like a teddy bear. People are treating these animals as members of the family rather than animals, aren't they? And that's part of the problem.
I agree with you. I think that, I like yourself, I've done hundreds, if not thousands, of these types of phone-ins, and invariably they come in the wake of a serious dog attack, and someone will say, this is terrible, but my dog is as good as gold. We leave it with our kids, we leave it with the grandkids, and I wince, because I'm a dog trainer by trade, And I've got two dogs, and if you were to say to me, my dogs, as you can probably guess, are pretty well trained, but if you were to say to me, would you leave your dogs or let them play with young members of the family, my answer would be no, absolutely not, for the simple reason that we people, we get up and have bad moods, and we do, if we're in a bad mood, we can snap at somebody. Why do people assume dogs can't do that? So you can have a dog that is perfectly well behaved for 99 days out of the year, and on that 100th day, it gets trod on, or it gets its favourite toy taken away, and dogs don't react to things the same way that people do. They don't do things the way that we do. So when you leave children and dogs unaccompanied, you are setting yourself up for a fall, and I think getting away from the idea that it's just Staffies or just Rottweilers or just Mastiffs, if we were to get rid of the Staffy, if I thought there was something fundamentally wrong with that breed, and if every other dog expert thought there was something fundamentally wrong with that breed, I think we'd all line up and say, we need to wipe them out. But it isn't that issue. If you wiped out every Staffy, you would have the same amount of dog attacks.
So why do we always hear, whenever there is a dog attack, we're just waiting for the fact that the news will say, and such a child has been attacked, the dog, a Staffordshire Bull Terrier, has been put down. Why is it always a Staffy? It's either the breed or Staffordshire Bull Terriers, and forgive me for sounding terribly politically incorrect when I say this, but Staffordshire Bull Terriers have become the dog of choice for the less educated.
Well, there's another angle, and that it's not always the Staffy, but the reporting of it is always the Staffy. Now, I cover dog attacks, and I can guarantee you that Staffies are nowhere near the top of the number one dog to admit people to hospital, nowhere near, but you've got there a powerful dog. And so if you get bitten on the hand by a Jack Russell Terrier, you'll go to casualty and you'll get stitches, but that won't make the news. And so dogs admit people to hospital through dog bites every day. Not all of them make the news. In terms of serious and fatal dog attacks, again, even in this country, the Staffordshire Bull Terrier is not the leading breed in that list. They are all different breeds.
But
so I think what we have to do is steer away from this idea that some breeds are more inherently dangerous or aggressive. I think every dog breed is potentially dangerous.
Well, they have the potential to attack, but they're not necessarily as dangerous, are they? Because isn't one of the other reasons we always hear about Staffordshire Bull Terriers being the ones that attack is that their mouths, their jaws, are so strong that when they bite, my God, do they bite. You know, they have that power in their mouths to be able to rip somebody's face off in the way that a Cavalier King Charles Spaniel physically doesn't. So when a Cavalier King Charles Spaniel bites somebody, it nips them. It doesn't necessarily rip their leg off.
Well, I think, again, there's a myth. I mean, there's a myth about Staffies and locking jaws, which, again, I think plays to my argument that they have been maligned. They don't have locking jaws. Complete myth. No dog does. I think if you're looking at dogs that have killed people, I've covered a report of a Labrador puppy doing it, and in France, a Pomeranian, a toy dog, killed a baby. So I think if we were to take the approach, we need to solve this problem, and the way to do that is eradicating certain breeds based on the ability to kill or seriously injure, we are going all the way down to the list and we'll be left with chihuahuas and nothing else. And so I think what we have to do is say we all want the same solution. We want a reduction in dog attacks, and 100% of that focus is on the person at the end of the lead. The breed, honestly, it's irrelevant. There are hundreds and thousands of Staffies in this country and millions of them around the world. And if they bite a child, they will cause serious injury. The issue is not eradicating the millions of Staffordshire Bull Terriers that aren't biting children. It's educating the people who are ignorant to what their dogs are capable of doing.
Okay, Ryan, always good to talk to you. Thanks for your time. Ryan O'Meara, who publishes Canine Magazine. Becky's